I'm here to share a few of my findings that we have done in our university research. The effect of thermal processing on phytic acid, inorganic phosphorus, and proximate composition of Pigeon pea. Moving towards background, in this section, I will describe why Pigeon pea is selected and why we're concerned in the phytic acids. Pigeon pea carcinous cousin plays an important role in cereal-based Asian diets, basically providing the major sources of protein, and it can be being used and can be used in a diverse way as a food, fodder, and a number of other therapeutic purposes as well. Presence of phytic acids is one of the main drawbacks limiting its nutritional quality. Phytic acids account for about 60 to 90% of the total phosphorus. Number of research has agreed with this statement. Because of its nature, complex nature, unique nature of the phytic acids, it forms interaction with proteins and minerals. This complex could not be broken down by the monogastric animals, and it has become increasingly important from the nutritional point of view. Whenever the nutrition, micronutrient intake is adequate, there might not be the significance of study on the phytic acids. But in most of the developing countries, the intake of most of the minerals, including iron, calcium, these are still limiting. That is why dietary phytate is often high in developing countries, whereas in also the this concern continues in developed countries, where the increasing trend of dietary fiber is gaining. Pigeon pea seeds also have appreciable amount of phytates, which adversely affect the bioavailability of certain vital nutrients. Some simple, inexpensive domestic processing methods were being used and can be used for the reduction of the phytates. Knowingly or unknowingly, we are using these simple, inexpensive domestic processing to reduce phytate levels. However, the processing can often affect negatively the nature and the concentration of the many nutrients. That is why the concern continues. The challenge is to determine the appropriate level of processing to optimum utilization of the grain legumes, including pigeon pea. Thus, this study was undertaken to investigate the effect of thermal processing, basically which types of thermal processing we use, I will discuss in later, the processing on phytic acid, inorganic phosphorus, and the effect of this processing on the basic proximate composition of the pigeon pea seeds. Diet containing high phytate not only impairs the important mineral absorption, but also reduces the phosphorus availability in the gut. Reducing the phytate thus has a dual benefits that will enhance the mineral absorptions as well as improve the phosphorus utilization. That is why a study on the influence of local food processing methods with regard to the phytate destruction is noteworthy. The methodology that we have done in our research is here. The materials measured dry and brown varieties of pigeon pea seeds were used for this research were purchased from the Chatara Sunsari, where the in Sunsari most of the pigeon pea is grown there, and all the chemicals and apparatus used for this study experiment was taken from the central laboratory of the Central Department of Food Technology and Central Campus of Technologies. The experimental methods goes like this. The all measured, dried, and grained pigeon pea seeds were taken, and control is taken as a raw seeds were taken as a control, and seeds were subjected to the two types of thermal processing, moist heating and the dry heating. In moist heating, seeds were cooked in atmospheric cook pressure, cooking in a borosilicate beaker. For experimental purpose, we use 100 grams of pigeon pea seeds with three times the weight of the seeds, that is 300 ml of distilled water for cooking, and it was cooked for 30 minutes. Similarly, in the pressure cooking treatments, pigeon pea seeds were cooked in a pressure cooker of capacity 1.5 liter for about the 15 minutes. And likewise, dry heating was done in a microwave oven, placing the seeds in a clean, dry, steel bowl and roasting the seeds for 5 minutes at around 200 degrees centigrade. All the treated samples were first cooled to the room temperature and ground, and finally subjected to the analysis. The proximate analysis, including the nitrogen-free extract calculated from the difference method, were done using the method described by the Rangana 2007. Inorganic phosphorus, phytic acids were calculated based on the simple laboratory procedure described by the Fiske and Sobro 1925 and Wheeler and Feller 1971. All the data were analyzed, done with the analysis of variance using the Zenistat release version 12.1. The result shows that about 895 milligram per 100 gram of phytic acid was present in the pigeon pea samples seeds we are using. Most of the literature has shown that pigeon pea seeds with brown varieties contains the higher amount of anti-nutrient factor, including the phytic acids. That is why we are gaining this range of phytic acid values. Inorganic phosphorus levels around 75.57%, phytate phosphorus about 252.29, and total phosphorus was found to be 337.83 milligram per 100 gram dry matter. Here we can see that about 75% of the total phosphorus was found to be phytate phosphorus. In the graph we can see that all the three types of heating treatment, thermal processing, how this processing reduced the phytate levels, the A, B, C means the significant differences at a level of significantly different at 95 level of confidence level. Here we can see that maximal reduction was found in pressurized seeds where 23.41% of phytic acid was reduced. At the same time, inorganic phosphorus content was increased by 77.39% from that of the control where we use the raw pigeon pea as a control. Likewise, the atmospheric cooking in which the seeds were cooked in a borosilicate beaker, it reduces the phytic acid, phytate level by only 17%, and the roasting reduces by the 18% with a concomitant increase in the inorganic phosphorus content by the 66% and 33% respectively. Here, the increase in inorganic phosphorus content was not only due to the destruction of the phytic acid, but also the heat-liable phosphates as well. Here you can see that the same treatment procedure taking the raw material as a control, how proximate compositions were varied with this processing. Basically, we are focusing on the protein S, nitrogen-free extract and crude proteins. Significant changes was also found, but the amount was seen not significant, reasonably low level, down to the not reasonably to the low level. Here we can see that the crude protein content was reduced to the, by the 14.43% by the pressure cooking treatment. Similarly, crude fat, as we consume pigeon pea not for the fat, but here we can see that fat content reduced by the 15.34%. S content, that is the mineral, we are taking the pigeon pea seed as a minerals, as a source of minerals as well. It was found to be reduced by the 21.81%, but in the values, it was less than around one something. Here we can see that all the processing treatments change the proximate value compositions as well, but not reasonably low level. That's why we came to the conclusion that increase in nitrogen-free extract and crude fiber is also this, the increasement in the digestible nutrients as well. In conclusion, we can say that both the dry and wet heating treatments reduce the proximate phytic acid reasonably low level without reasonably changing the proximate components. Thus, we can use the heat processing treatments as a developing countries as a means of the one of the best method for reducing the anti-nutrients factors as well. Thank you.